teachers have done with them, because at home it's very difficult to get them to do anything, because when they're with their parents, they don't listen to them. But you can see what the teachers have done with them, and to perform in a language which is totally new. English is totally new to the little ones, but then they knew when they have to come, when they have to begin whatever they had to begin, and when they had to stop. Even while they were dancing, you can imagine the practice that must have, the teachers must have had such a lot of practice with them, and so much time must have been spent with them. But I know that when they are in school, it's easier to mold them because they listen to their teachers. And I was looking at, this is what we all do on the stage, we mark the stage. And because they are too small to know where they are supposed to stand. And that takes a lot of time, patience, but for the children also to know, I am in this circle or I am in this square. Now that is also a learning process for the children. They knew when to pick up their pots, they knew when to put them down, they knew when to put their pans down, when to pick them up. And that involves a lot of training, and for that I must congratulate the teachers, and I think they need a big round of applause. It is not easy to handle children. The little ones are my all-time favorites. I was with the little ones for a long time before I became the principal of the senior school, and I still love to go to the little ones because they are so refreshing. The bigger ones have other problems, and sometimes they really, you know, you're tense with all their problems. But then when you go to the little ones, they are a joy, and they are like a stress reliever when you see their innocence. The other day I was telling some of our little ones in Loreto, I said, please don't grow. They said, okay, sister. Now they didn't know what I was trying to say. I said, don't grow. Remain like this. All right, sister. Thank you, sister. This is what we must treasure these years. And I know now you're appreciating them so much. Please continue doing that even when they grow up. Because somewhere down the line, parents give up on the children and they think they can be on their own. And I know even when they're in plus one and two, they still need you. When they're small like this, and if you don't come for their concerts or whatever, they will cry and they will tell you that they are upset. When they are big, they also feel upset. They may not cry, but sometimes they tell us. They say our parents don't bother, they don't want to come. So show this appreciation even when they grow up. I know now they are, you know, they're so cute, and even when I have to pull them, push them, whatever, they don't know where to stand. And these are their growing up years. And we love them at this stage. Continue loving them even when they grow. And the problems begin with the children, because somewhere there is a communication gap that happens between parents and children. So let them be like how they are now. You saw the innocence in those little ones. Keep them that way. Let them come to you whenever they have little problems. Listen to them. Give them your time. What is most important with little ones and bigger ones also, with children, they need their parents to listen to them, mothers to listen to them, fathers to listen to them. But nowadays, with so many constraints, and to make ends meet, both parents have to work. And when you come back from your work, when the children are trying to tell you something, you have no time. You say, "Acha beta, theek hai, baad mein batao." And that is where then, you know, they feel, their little hearts, they are not able to say, but they know that you are saying, "Now, not now, go away from me." So don't do that, parents, because you have been given these children as a gift from God. They belong more to God than to you. You are only the caretakers. So you have to answer. One day if they go away, you have to answer God, because they are God's gift to you. And please treasure them. I also like to thank Ma'am Gurneet Kaur for inviting me today. In the beginning I said, you know, I have so many things happening because of this Teachers' Day, it's coming. and we have to bring it a little forward. I said, I have practices, I have this, I have that. So she said, no, sister, just for a little while, just for a little while. And I'm glad I came because, as I said, little ones are my all-time favorites. And when I'm with little ones, I forget everything. So, and today, it was a lovely morning for all of us. And I'm sure you also enjoyed the little ones here. And you also would say the same thing, please don't grow, remain where you are, because that's such a beautiful age. And they grow so fast. After a few years, that will go and they will be a little more mature. So, and you would like the clock to turn back and say, I wish they were that kind, you know, so sweet and so good. So once again, thank you parents also for coming, because that gives and that encourages the children. Thank you, the staff, and thank you for inviting me. And I would like to thank the little children. They won't understand what I'm trying to say, but I want to thank them also for giving me a lovely morning. And when I thank them, I thank you parents, because you are the ones, if you were not there, these children would not have been there. So it is because of you that these children are here. So thank you, and thank everyone over here. God bless you.